Everybody. Okay, hello, hello. So today we're going to show you guys a circuit. My mom is going to be starting with barbell bent over rows. This is meant to be her heavy movement of the circuit. So she is definitely paying attention to squeezing the muscles, but we don't care if body English gets in there. Good, she got 5 reps. So 5 reps represents kind of a heaviness weight that where 5 is difficult, you get stronger from that effort. Now we're moving to lat pull downs. And she's going to be going for 10 reps, and she's going to slow this one down and focus more on the muscles. So what we're doing today is we're actually going to put together a circuit and show you something that works on strength. It works on muscle kind of manipulation, where if you eat extra food after this workout, if you eat in a caloric surplus, you would grow muscles. If you eat at caloric maintenance, you'd get better shape in the muscles you're working. So it kind of manipulates the muscles whichever way you want. So if you're a male, you can do the structure. If you're a female, you can do the structure. If you're male or female wanting to build muscle, this structure works. You just got to eat enough. If you're male or female wanting to not necessarily build muscle, but just get better shape, this structure works as well. If you eat in a caloric maintenance level or even deficit if you're trying to lose weight. So now we're going to our second kind of muscle manipulation movement, and this is an underhanded chest supported row. So it works similar muscles as the barbell row, but this is more controlled since we're on a chest supported movement rather than allowing her to use her legs and lower back. And the underhand helps change which muscles of the back it's working. So overall, that's what this structure is intended for. So we're picking back exercises today, but you can pick chest exercises or legs. You can kind of do it for any body part you want. So we're doing a set of 5 of the strength movement, then sets of 10 of the muscle manipulation movements. So Mama's going to take a rest. Go ahead and breathe, Mom. I'm going to keep you guys going. So we're going to come on back over here. So what we're doing with the first movement is we're picking something that uses the heaviest weight you can use, like kind of for that muscle group. So for my mom, we know we can do heavier barbell bent over rows than she can do the chest supported row. So the chest supported row whole contraption might weigh say 20 pounds, and we have 7.5 over there, so maybe 30 pounds. Whereas over here, she's barbell bent over rowing 115. So we can definitely get more weight moved on this one. And we're doing it for 5 reps or less to make sure we work on strength. So this is going to be her strength building movement. Okay. Then we would come in over here and we're doing lat pull downs because since a barbell bent over row, when she's in that position, it stresses her lower back to hold her at the right angle. Well, lat pull downs is no lower back stress at all. So after a movement that's hard on the lower back, if she were to do another one that involved the upper back but also stress the lower back, she might start to only feel her lower back. Whereas this allows the lower back to relax. So we still get to work on the lats in the back, but we get that lower back to relax. And then she came over to this movement, and it is chest supported row, so the chest support allows you to use a little bit less lower back as well, but it's still more involved in this movement than it is on a lat pull down. But now that she had the rest of the lat pull down where she didn't use her back is now able to be a little bit more used in this one. So we're kind of trading off lower back intensive in the first movement, not involved in the second, and then somewhat involved in the third, so that way we can not overly tax her lower back as we're trying to actually tax her upper back. So we'll come back for another round and more description. Okay, here we are for another round. You can go ahead and start, Mom. So what I wanted to explain in this one is when you set this stuff up, what it does is you have your kind of bigger, heavier movement first. You got your 2 secondary movements. Typically with all this stuff, they're all going to require at least 1 or 2 warm-up sets to where you kind of take some time to get to the heavier set. And that's typically how this structure works, is you pick the 3 exercises you want. You do 1 to 2 warm-ups, or even a third if you need it for the bigger movement, the strength movement. But you get all the movements warmed up to where you find out what weight you need for your first working set. And then you start them all together at the first same round for their first working sets. So we didn't do any heavier sets of rows before we were ready for these ones. And we didn't do these ones any heavier before we were ready for the rows. So they all started at the first working set together. So typically you have 1, 2, maybe even 3 warm-up sets. And then we aim for 3 to 5 rounds of it being very difficult. So those are your working sets, the sets that take work. So you look for 3 to 5 rounds. If the working sets were super duper freaking hard and you're about ready to die, 3 rounds is probably enough. If you started maybe a little too light and you knew that first working set really wasn't maximal effort, you might need a 4th or a 5th round to kind of get more out of the work, to get what's needed for that day to make a complete workout. So you need four or five if the first working sets are kind of a little too easy. If they're murderous, you can get away with three. And typically, all of this stuff can get done in under 30 minutes. So we're actually going to get a complete back workout in under 30 minutes. You would pick your three movements, you get your one, two, maybe even three warm-up sets, you do your 3 to 5 rounds, and that can be done in 30 minutes. Now, today's one, we get the benefit of Kajumbum. So we get the benefit of using machines and stuff in this gym. So we have this machine taken up, we have our lat machine taken up, and we have that deadlift platform all taken up. But you can see in the middle of the day, it's pretty chill here, so not too many people around. So it allows us the ability to kind of use multiple pieces of equipment in multiple spaces. If you're doing this circuit in a busy gym, you might have to stay just on this platform and pick secondary exercises that use things like kettlebells or weighted balls or even dumbbells to where you can stay in one area. So the next video we make about this circuit, I'll show you guys how to do that with a structure in which you'd have to stay in one area or only use one piece of equipment. So for today, we're having fun while we can, and we're using a lot more equipment. So hopefully you guys found this circuit helpful. We'll come and make another circuit in the next couple days, just give you guys more description. So if you like this, hopefully you can put it to use and see if you can beat yourself up doing it.